When we want to understand the reactivity of carbonyl compounds, we have to remember that the carbonyl group, the carbon double bonded to the oxygen, is very polar because the oxygen is a very electronegative atom relative to the carbon. This means that the carbonyl carbon is electron deficient. Therefore, the carbon can undergo nucleophilic association, and the pi bond will break, and we'll get a tetrahedral intermediate forming. Once we have the tetrahedral intermediate, there's different things that can happen depending on which type of carbonyl compound we have. You should recall from the previous videos about carbonyl compounds that we introduced them into two different classes or types. The first type were the acyl chlorides, carboxylic acids, esters, and amides, and they were related because the Y group on the carbonyl carbon would have a reasonably good chance of leaving. The second type of carbonyl compounds, including aldehydes and ketones, had a Y group that was not a very good leaving group. The type 1 carbonyl compounds will follow reaction mechanisms that involve some kind of substitution. However, the aldehydes and ketones, or type 2 carbonyl compounds, will undergo an addition type of mechanism. When we look at reactions of carboxylic acids, acyl chlorides, esters, and amides, the tetrahedral intermediates that are formed will have bonds to the carbonyl carbon with two very electronegative atoms. These kinds of tetrahedral intermediates are fairly unstable. When we have these unstable tetrahedral intermediates, the weaker base of the Y and the Z will end up leaving. If the nucleophile that was added, Z, is the weaker base of the two, then there will be no change from the original reactant. This means that there's generally going to be no reaction if the nucleophile is a weaker base than the leaving group, Y. However, if the leaving group Y is a weaker base than the nucleophile Z, then we will get a new product. You should recall that in general, the chlorides will be very weak bases and therefore good leaving groups. The alkoxides, or hydroxides, will be intermediate in their ability to act as leaving groups, whereas the amide ions, NH2-, will be strong bases and therefore poor leaving groups. The mechanism involved from these tetrahedral intermediates is called nucleophilic acyl substitution. In short, we can start with one of these type 1 carbonyl compounds, react it with a nucleophile, and the nucleophile Z will substitute for the leaving group Y. When we look at the reactivity of aldehydes and ketones, the fact that aldehydes have a hydrogen and ketones have an alkyl group or carbon group attached to the carbonyl carbon means that these two types of carbonyl compounds will have a different kind of mechanism because the hydrogen anion or the alkyde anion are very strong bases and so do not want to leave. Aldehydes and ketones will instead undergo a different kind of reaction known as a nucleophilic addition reaction. In these kinds of reactions, the pi bond between the carbon and oxygen is broken, and two different atoms will be added, one to the oxygen of the carbonyl, and the other, the nucleophile, to the carbon of the carbonyl. When we compare the general reactivity trends of all of these carbonyl compounds, we'll see that the acyl chlorides will be most reactive and undergo substitution reactions. Aldehydes and ketones will be next most reactive and they'll undergo addition reactions. Esters and carboxylic acids are next most reactive, and amides are least reactive. All three of these last types of carbonyl compounds will undergo substitution reactions.